hygiene, wearing an N95 mask and wearing full PPE, and more importantly, doffing the full PPE are vital to keep healthcare workers free from infections during this epidemic. The first thing that we will be demonstrating now is hand cleaning. We will be giving you alcohol-based solutions. They will be having around 70% alcohol, and this is used for hand rub. Remember, if you do not have alcohol-based solutions, you can use soap water, soap and water. This is as effective as alcohol-based solution. But we will be demonstrating here how to use an alcohol solution. The first thing is remove all electronic devices and things like watches. It is preferable that women do not wear earrings. All men have to have shaved their beard compulsorily. Women have to not have any bangs. So the reason is that the area where the N95 mask fits is dependent on a seam between the N95 and the skin. Now, if that is broken, the N95 mask is essentially useless. So please remember that you have to have perfect fit. Another reason why area around the thing should not be covered by bang or beard is the fit of the hood is also critical. And if you have hair in that region, it will obstruct the integrity of the hood. Another reason is that the virus can be on your hair, and therefore it is important that when you are in full PPE, you should not have any exposed part. The new PPE will become your new skin. Now, first, take a liberal amount of sanitizer and rub. Now, important things that you have to do is do not do it too fast. Alcohol works only if it dries out. Now, when you are rubbing like this, please see that the web spaces are included. The first web space is commonly the area which is missed. You please. The other important thing is nails. Everyone has to have trimmed their nails. After doing it, scrub and see that your nails are also fully done. So now that when we are fully satisfied with the hand rub, allow it to dry. It is important that the alcohol dries. It is not to be waved around like this. It has to be allowed to dry. This is especially important in the doffing area where there may be a viral load and you are not supposed to be drying out. PPE donning is a slow procedure. It has to be done thoroughly with one person wearing it and the other person checking. The checking person is called as the compliance officer. No stage should be hurried. Please remember, errors in PPE donning can lead to disability and death. Removal is the most dangerous portion. Now we have cleaned our hands. The hand has dried. The compliance officer is going to check that the hand is dry. Next, wearing the PPE. N95 masks are actually come in different sizes, but there is a shortage of PPE in India and as well as in the rest of the world. So we will be making additional protocols for loose PPE. But I will be now showing you a standard PPE donning. This is a PPE. It has got a nasal clip. The cloth is a special type of cloth which has a 95% filtration capacity. There are two elastic bands. There is usually a nose clip. Do not use the ones without nose clip. There are certain brands which are there which are not having a nose clip that will not work for medical N95 mask. The first step is hold the N95 mask and cup it in your hand. Now keep the elastic like this. You can see that. Now place it over your mouth and nose. bring this over. Now take one above, one below. For additional safety, you will put it above your head. This ensures that the lower seal is better. Now, remember, this is not the end of wearing the mask. The next step is that this must be absolutely tight. The nasal bridge is one of the areas where leak will occur. Next, cup your hand and fit the mask. Next step, keep your hands apart. Breathe in and out as it is being done and check if a blast of air is occurring. The next thing that the compliance officer does is see, can you see the retraction and the propulsion of the mask? This means it is probably okay. The next step is fit test. Everyone must undergo mandatorily one fit test. This doctor. It is mandatory that with the first N95 mask use, you have to be fit tested. There are various types of fit testing. And we will be using in our hospital two types of fit tests. One will be the agarbatti or incense stick smoke test and the other is the air freshener test. Please note and follow this. Compliance officer has to see that this is done perfectly to ensure that the mask fit is perfect. It is also vital that in case we have to reuse our N95 mask, that every reuse has to be qualified with a fit test. Okay, every reuse has to be done with a fit test. Okay, the first step for the fit test, is the mask fitting properly? The compliance officer will go around the margin of the nose. I should not be able to hear. If I get any smell, I have to repeatedly adjust. I am not able to smell the mask if it is not informed the compliance officer. Now, once the fit test is done properly and everything is in place, I ask the person to close the eyes. Compliance officer asks to close the eyes. Can you please close the eyes? I should not get the smell of the. If I get, please inform the compliance officer and readjust your mask. That after this, when you are fully breathing, repeat the smoke test. If it is not, please tell the compliance officer. For if there is ill fitting, we will be giving a different method to help fit the mask. Because we are having only one size of mask available and there is a shortage of mask. So now we have worn the mask. The next step is to wear the PPE. The PPE that has been provided to us is having the following thing. There is the full PPE, which the model is what I am going to call as the Baba suit. This is one form of PPE. This mandatorily requires two people to wear. The next thing in the kit are nitrile gloves. We will be trying to get different types of nitrile gloves for different hand sizes, but they have provided in the kit one. Even if it's not a proper fit, please wear a nitrile glove at least inside. What is the advantage of the nitrile glove is that it is less, it is more resistant to puncture and spontaneous breakage compared to latex glove. So this is a nitrile glove. There is an over mask, there are over masks like this. there is a goggle. We may have to, this goggle has one issue that the lower end, that people with specs have to remove their spec, and there is a problem of it in this, but we will have to make particular adjustments for this. But so wear your goggle. There is another type of goggle, those who have it can use this goggle. If this goggle is being used, this will be the last thing you want. Whereas if you are using Baba suit, you have to wear this first, because it doesn't sit over the ear when you put the hood. I will be demonstrating both depending on what is available. Next, you will have to remove shoes and socks. We will be providing gum boots and you will have to wear the gum boots over the truck. Because if you are not having a single set Baba suit, you can do it in stages. If the place to sit, please remember, now how does this PPE look? It is an integrated PPE. There is a zip line and there is a sticker. We may be in a position where we may have to reuse the PPE. In that case, the final step where we are going to put the sticker, and it has to be supplemented with another tape over it, if we come to that situation. We do not know how the pandemic will run, but we have to be prepared for all in situations. Remember, the PPE is not meant to be sterile. This is going to be your second skill. Any procedure that is going to be done requires additional cover over it, as if this is your skin. So PPE need not be sterile. Do not say, I don't have a sterile PPE, so I cannot go in. No, this is going to be your new skin. First step, check the PPE. Unroll the PPE, see that all seams are intact. Important areas to check for seams are in the crotch, in the armpit, and along their leg. Once you are satisfied with the integrity of the PPE, unzip the PPE. Now, sit down and put your legs in. Get the legs in first. Stand up. Zip up. Put the hood on. Now, the next part is important. The upper part of the PPE has to cover the eyebrow. Now you will see here that this PPE does not have a proper fit. Now this is the role of the compliance officer. Come. You will take a piece of card, and the job of the person is to see that it cannot be easily introduced. If there is any gap, ideally there should be no gap. If there is a gap, she will take plaster, open the plaster, and take it around. Just stop the recording. Tape all the areas which are missed. So, start taping. You can take tape.
supposed to.
Take your time. You can take pieces. This side is not required. Here. This is the typical area where taping may be required. Okay. Now I just see that your vision is also unobstructed. Now the hold is optional. Face shield can be used, but the idea is now that nothing can be. The nitrile gloves are unsterile, and you will wear it as per usual protocol. Important thing, when you wear the nitrile glove, you may use double gloves. Remember to use one size. When you are using these nitrile gloves, it would be okay to use a looser. See that the seal is maintained. If required, get a tie down by the compliance officer. Now I am in full PPE. I can wear gumboots over this to complete the PPE. You can see no part of my body is now exposed. Raise your hand, resisting, raise your legs, confirm that everything is okay. Wide movement. Can you just stop? The compliance officer has to see that a person before wearing full PPE has to have consumed adequate amount of water, has passed urine, has gone to stools, and has eaten food. It is better to eat food, drink water, and then pass urine and pass stools, because gastrocolic reflex may occur and you may want to pass stool. It is optional to wear a diaper inside. Why? Once you go into the area, you cannot come out. Women who have to wear menstrual pads have to have double pads or tampons. It is very vital that all of you are aware of this, because once I wear this PPE, I cannot at any cost remove it in the isolation room. You are not allowed to drink water, you are not allowed to eat, and you cannot pass urine, you cannot pass stool. So that is the rule. Breaking this rule can threaten your life. This PPE is uncomfortable to wear. We will have to work in groups of 4 hours each. It is very difficult to work for more than 4 hours because it is hot, it is humid, and we will not be having AC in the room. We can at the most have fans, which will be pretty useless. Wearing this is difficult, but it is vital. However much that you feel that I am uncomfortable, do not remove the PPE. It is vital. Another important thing, let us assume that there is a cardiac arrest or something. In that ward, you cannot rush to the patient without full PPE. That is why in the ICU there, one person, when he goes in, one set goes in, there will always be for a short period of time a period when some people are removing the PPE and some people are going to be wearing the PPE. So there will always be somebody there. Remember, CPR, intubation are very high aerosol generating procedures. This is the time when there is a maximum load. Remember, in Lombardy area of Italy, 20% of the healthcare workers have got infected because they did not follow PPE rules. 20%. Whole of Italy, 8%. Now, we have now worn the PPE. Can you stop? And now the most important part is removing the PPE. You must now realize I have a infected area around me. This is called as dirty area. Inside me, surface is clean area. The rule is dirty to dirty, clean to clean. Now I want everyone to practice, because though it looks easy, it is actually difficult to do. The first step of removing the PPE is hand sanitization. Compliance officer will also be in full PPE. Please don't. The compliance officer now, because he is in dirty area, you are in dirty. The compliance officer is one of your nurses who will be either just come in, or one of them, one other person has a buddy who will be checking. So it is always in buddy. We will be training everyone to do two roles. One is the wearer and the other is the compliance officer. Do not remove without a compliance officer. It can be lethal. For testing purposes, where is the powder? Powder is not. Training purpose is you will put powder over the person. This is the virus. This is the compliance officer's job during the training. We will be doing training where people put it over. She is the compliance officer. Assume that she is in very full PPE. Now, put it over. The goal now, we will be putting liberal powder. The goal is that you should try to remove without the powder falling on. In essence, the bacteria, that is why it is important to train. Many people think, oh, I am wearing an OT gown. This is not the same as wearing an OT gown, because this removal is very stringent. Now, it has to be done on the back. Now, the first step is hand sanitization, because you are going to use your hand. Same process, what we told. In our hospital, we will be having a slightly different protocol, where we will be doing primary decontamination with hypochlorite solution. This will require both the buddy and the wearer to act in concert. We may be running into a shortage of PPEs, which has happened in all of the countries over the world, and we do not want to have a situation where we will have no PPEs. So we will be decontaminating and we will be storing these after sterilization in case we run out of PPEs. What we will be doing is we will be taking the stock and we will be providing a bucket containing hypochlorite solution. What we will be doing is adding 1 teaspoon per liter of, and it should be prepared fresh for every batch. Which are, you will put the solution, the 1 spoon of bleaching powder per liter into a bucket, swirl it and allow it to decant. The solution is hypochlorite. You will take a mop, which is going to be thrown away later, dip it into the hypochlorite solution and start your scrub. The role of the buddy compliance officer is to see that the thing is completely covered with hypochlorite. Now, it is impossible for you to do the back surface, so the other person will rub the, she will be in full PPE, will completely scrub down the person. So this is primary desanitizer. So full rub, full. Everywhere, person has to take care of the crotch area, the back, the ankle, wherever you can think of, all those areas have to be done. This is just primary desanitization. It does not mean that this is clean. Assume that it is not clean. Now, the first step is release the sticker and open the suit. The next step is compliance officer helps to remove any tape. It is not advisable to place tape, but if we have placed the tape, we have to remove it. Next step is remove the hood. See how I am doing it. Please note, remove the hood and keep it open. Now comes the difficult part. Hold here. Hold the shoulder. Hold the shoulder. Now you can see I am like this. Now, hold like this. Hold like this. Unravel. Can you see how I am doing? Unravel. Now hold your hand and the glove and pull this nitrate. Coat this side and now we are having sterile. Now comes the important part when contamination can occur. You will roll. Now you will sit down. You will bring the chair. The chair will come from far away. You will roll. And you see, at more time, even a bit of powder has not fallen out of me. This is picked up, held like this and put from afar into the bin. It is kept in the designated bin. Next, this end is inside. It is removed, kept again in a receptacle for this. Now comes the difficult part of removing the mask. Head is to be bent forward. Strap is to be put back if it in relation to the ear. Please bend forward. Bring it like this forward and it settles down like this. I will be showing you the same maneuver from the side. Assume that first step is, if you have worn it above for a better seam down, bring it behind. Bring this forward. Bend forward. Bring it like this. Hold it like this. Walk to the relevant bin and place it inside. This is the way to, now, after this, sanitize your hand. You will use the same process I told you, full hand sanitization. Consider this as dirty. First base is important. Nails and everything is wet. And wait till it dries. It is very important now in the doffing room where there is a potential higher viral load to not wave your hands like this. You are now technically in the clean area now. Now you have to exit the room. In our COVID ward, we do not have separate entrance and exit. So the protocol that will be followed is the clean team, which wears the new set, will enter into the corridor. There are two doors. The door with the doffing group will be closed. All those people who are doffing will be inside this side. They will enter. All the nurses, excepting the nurse who is going to be the compliance nurse, goes in. She will do the compliance work, and in the meantime, a second nurse starts. Second clean nurse who has just entered in will fumigate the corridor. We are going to close these doors of the doffing room and close the thing. So now the dirty area where the people have come in, all the doctors, nurses and group D who have come in are now isolated in the doffing area. Now this has become that corridor becomes clean after fumigating, and when the go is given, the nurses inside will open, shut the fogger off, and they will exit. But the compliance officer remains behind, and what they will do is they will now take all of these. All these masks have to be signed and kept ready, and we will be putting it in the UV chamber for one possible reuse. You can only reuse this once with the thing, provided you do the smoke test and the thing. If it qualifies, use it. If it is not there, we will have to use a new N95 mask. We will be reusing only N95 mask in a situation where we will not be having any N90 mask. Let us, God forbid, that does not happen. The other person, the compliance officer now, he is in full PPE, will unroll the mask, reject the nitrile gloves and other things which are there, check the PPE for integrity. Remember, please check this properly, because your colleague's life will depend upon it. So check for seams, check for blood splatter. If there is blood splatter, you can use peroxide to sterilize. Now you assume that I am in full PPE, you will check. After checking all the seams and if there is pus, we will be discarding it. But if there is, otherwise if the PPE per se is clean, we will reuse it. You will pack. Now when you pack, the problem is that air tends to settle down at the base. So fold it and fold it in this manner so that the air comes out. Everyone must know how to do it. In a problem, doctors, nurses, everybody has to be able to do this, because who knows, and fold it. Now, this is now in a pack. We will be providing ETO packs. You will put it into the ETO pack, but you will not seal it. Now, you will store the things in a row in the doffing area. After this is done, that room will now be fumigated. Understood? Now, this fumigation will take care of the outer cover of the ETO pack and this thing. And after the period is over, the person who is inside will have to keep the door open for entry inside. But they will not do anything. The next batch which is going to come in, who is remaining clean? Now one person has come and done the protocol, another person is waiting just outside the corridor. He will come back in and he will seal the ETO bags. That area is now ETO bag, and then put it into a bigger bag and seal it. This will be handed out for reprocessing. So the entire process is now sterile. The clean person is coming into a clean area where the thing and is missing, and it will be sent out. This will be sent to PSST for processing per ETO, and it will be kept. If we run shortage of PPE, we will reuse this only, then we will reuse. This is just for our safety factor. Please remember, do not try to do these procedures fast. Your life depends on doing it slowly. That your life depends on a team of two checking and correcting. There is no ego in this. If it is not okay, say it is not okay. Doctor, maybe ward boy, maybe nurse, maybe anybody. If anyone faces a breach of the PPE protocol, please call it out loud, because you are doing a favor to the other person by calling out that there is a abnormality in the PPE donning or in the doffing procedure. I would say everyone in teams of five will practice. There will be five today who will be taught as the nurses will be taught to don, and five will be taught to doff, and you will reverse the role. These people will be the primary teachers after me. I will be conducting one class per day for the next week, but the others have to learn, and then they have to start teaching. We will prepare this video so that if the video will be run, you can stop it. Don it properly. If you are comfortable in your PPE, you have not worn it properly. Think that if you are comfortable, what is wrong? Because if you don't identify that what is wrong, it can pose a health hazard risk to you.